Examination of the heart. Examination of the heart is performed with the patient lying supine and the upper body undressed. Begin with a general inspection, which can reveal signs of cardiac illnesses. For example, a thoracotomy scar can indicate a history of cardiac surgery, and distended neck veins can be a sign of heart failure or superior vena cava syndrome. Palpation of the apex heartbeat is best performed with the patient lying on the left side. To feel the beat, place your hand on the thorax in the area of the cardiac apex. Note that it is not always palpable. Normally, the beat should be felt on the midclavicular line of the fifth intercostal space, or ICS, of the left hemithorax. If cardiac dilatation is present, the apex beat is widened and displaced caudally and laterally. Auscultation is a key technique to assess the cardiac rhythm and possible cardiac disorders. You can facilitate auscultation by asking the patient to hold the breath after exhaling. This reduces the damping effect of the lungs and eliminates distracting breathing sounds. Auscultation of the Erbs point, located on the third ICS on the left sternal border, is useful for a quick and general assessment of the heart. All heart sounds are often audible here, both pathological and physiological. The Erbs point can also be used to check the heart rate, which should always be compared to the peripheral pulse to detect a possible pulse deficit. To correctly identify heart sounds as systolic or diastolic, especially in tachycardia, palpate the pulse of the carotid artery as the first heart sound occurs simultaneously to the carotid pulse. Auscultate the individual valves in the following locations. Aortic valve, second ICS at the right sternal border. Pulmonary valve, second ICS at the left sternal border. Tricuspid valve, fourth ICS at the right sternal border. Mitral valve, fifth ICS at the left midclavicular line. Locating the second ICS is facilitated by first palpating the sternal angle. Assessing the aortic valve always requires auscultation of the carotid arteries as well, since murmurs, caused by aortic stenosis, often radiate to the carotids. Instruct the patient to lean forward, which makes auscultating both the pulmonary and the aortic valve easier. Auscultation of the mitral valve is best performed with the patient in the left lateral decubitus position. Mitral valve murmurs radiate to the fifth left ICS at the level of the anterior axillary line.